Magandang araw, class. Welcome to our subject, Engineering Economy. Today, we will talk about service output method. Something about the service output method, class, is this. Hindi naman, di ba, tuwing bumibili tayo, especially sa mga construction. Let's say you are investing in equipment. Let's say, backhoe for you to excavate, for you to collect soil, for you to collect construction waste, and so on and so forth. That investment will give high returns in your projects, in your business. But, meron yung wear and tear. Diba? As a machine, it depreciates its value. So, ganun din ang pag-uusapan natin dito. An investment that depreciates over time. Ano pa mga example nito? Kotse, di ba? Bumababa yung value. Ano lang ba yung mga tumataas? I would say real estate, no? I would say funds in investment, capital index. Example. Yan, papataas yung mga yan. So, without further ado, allow me to share my screen. So, let's talk about service output. Mabilis lang to, by the way. It's a very quick module. Same as the previous ones. And pag-usapan na agad natin, class, yung problem. Di ba? Mag-solve na agad tayo ng mga... So, for example, an equipment cost 480,000 pesos. Let's take note of the values. No? And as a salvage value of 10% of its... cost. Okay, meaning 48,000 na lang pag binenta mo siya at the end of what? 5 years. Yun lang daw kasi yung buhay niya. Okay, yun lang daw yung value na kayang i-withstand ng equipment na yun. Probably nga yung mga backhoe yan, mga boom truck mo, no? Pero, meron pa tayong binigay na economic life dito. An economic life given of 36,000 hours. In the first year, it has been used for 7,000 hours. At the end of second year, 15,000. Now, we are asked to find the total depreciation. Ano na lang yung halaga niya at the end of second year. Okay? So, some values na kailangan lang natin maalala dito. Actually, it's called the straight line method. It's a very easy approach in problems like this. Okay? So, sige, ganito lang yung kadali, class. Kung maaalala nyo yung mga given, no? 36,000 hours, 480,000 yung present niya, present investment, 480K pesos, di ba? Salvage value, that will be 48,000 pesos, okay? Pero may binigay na data na 36,000 hours in a span of 5 years. If you are asked to find ang normal via straight line method, no, solution, straight line methodology, pag uniform yung approach ng depreciation, ang mangyayari sa kanya, class, is this. Diba? That will be simply depreciation B. Sige, palitan natin yung color para ganda naman. Gawin natin yung color. Yung solution. Using the straight line method, the depreciation is equivalent to the present minus the salvage value all over the total number of years, the time. So that's simply 480,000 minus 48,000 all over, ilang years yun? On the end of 5 years. Diba? Now, hindi ko ito isosolve. Bakit? Kasi may binigay sa atin na economic life of ours. Ibig sabihin, ideally, no, about 7,000 hours siya per year. Diba? 7,000, 14,000, 21,000, 28,000, 35,000, approximately. Diba? Lumampas nga ng kaunti dito sa second year, 15,000 hours na agad. Yun yung magiging basehan natin. So, via solving, actually, dimensional analysis na lang din ito, eh. Diba? That will be The depreciation is equivalent to the present value minus the salvage value all over what? All over the total lifespan of 36,000 hours multiplied by what? 15,000 hours. Yun na. Di ba? Nakita niyo dito, class? By having the dimension analysis, solve natin siya. Very basic lang. So that will be D. Allow me to solve na, no? For, where's my calculator? 480,000 minus 48,000 all over 36,000 multiplied by 15,000. Diba? That will be the depreciation. So at the end of year 2, that will be equivalent to 180,000. Pag binenta natin, equipment natin at year 2. Okay. The depreciated amount. Ganun lang kadali, no? Ganun lang kadali. Next problem. An equipment cost, what if ganito na class, no? We are asked to find the capital recovery. Dito na mahaba yung formula, no? Dito na medyo mahaba yung formula natin. So the given formula for cases na given yung capital recovery, gagamit na tayo ng future worth. So, teka lang ha. Kunin ko lang yung ano na. Meron tayong kodigo dito. So the formula for capital recovery is this. Meron na tayo dito ng present worth and the initial investment. So nag-iba lang no, mag-iba lang dito class yung formula natin for magiging I natin yung initial, hindi siya P noon. Ano yung ginamit natin? P na yung ginamit natin variable. So, sorry about that. The capital recovery is equivalent to the initial investment I. Ito na, na-miss nyo ba to? And finding A given P with the interest amount with N periods minus the salvage value multiplied by A given F. Sorry. N periods. Okay. So dito, sa-isay na natin, class. So the initial investment, the given are the following. I is equivalent to 480K. Time is 'yan, tama. N is 5 years, no? I is equivalent to 10%. So, ganun lang kadali. Okay? Okay. So, the question here is this. Ang salvage value natin is 10% ulit. So that will be the salvage value is 480,000 multiplied by, di ba? 0.1 or 10%. That will be 48. Baka mamaya hindi yun na nasolve ko na. So, yun na. Solving further, one-liner equation. No? 480,000 A given P, finding A given P with I is equivalent to 10% and N is equal to 5 years. That is equivalent to 0 point. Buuin na natin muna. 48,000. A given F. I. 10%. 10% and 5 years. Okay? So the capital recovery at the end of 5 years is the following. So ito, value nito class is itong value niyan and value nito ay and then ito naman is 1.638. Okay? So solving further, we'll have the following: 480,000 multiplied by 0.2638. That will give us, sorry about this, masyadong mahaba. 624 minus 48,000 times 1.638. 78,624. So the answer will be 126. That will be 48,000. Okay? Capital recovery at the end of 5 years. Di ba nag-gets yung class? Ang haba ng formula, pero parang sinolvin pala natin yung, di ba na-derive natin yung salvage value niya? Kasi yun na yung magiging capital recovery if you want to recover the equipment's value by the end of year 5. Di ba? So, yun lang. Yun lang kadali. Okay? And finally, number 3. Let's say we have the following. A certain machine cost 40,000 and has a life of 4 years and salvage value of 5,000. The production output of this machine in units per year is 1,000 and 2,000 for the second year, 3,000 and so on and so forth. So ngayon pa lang dito class na may idea na tayo na pwede na lang simple line method na naman to, di ba? This is just a simple line method approach. Okay? So, ano yung mag-given natin ulit? Principal, 40,000. Salvage value of 5,000. Ilang percent yun? So that will be 20%, no? Tama ba? Hindi. 5 divided by 40,000. 5,000 divided by 40,000. Okay, 0.125%, what are 12.5% salvage value. Okay, the production is by 1,000 units increment. Okay. So, straight line method na naman. Ganun lang kadali ito. That will be, the depreciated amount will be P minus S over. Diba? Actually, ito total mo pala. No? Ito total natin yung salvage value niya. Ay, yung mga units. So, that will be 1,000 plus 2,000. Diba? Sa summary niya eh. And so on and so forth until the fifth year plus 5,000 siguro yan. So that will be 1,000 plus 2,000, 3,000, 10,000, total of 15,000 po. Tama ba? Tama. 15,000 yung total number of units. So we are asked to find the depreciation after the fourth year. So that will be 4,000 units. So this is units over units to. Ganun lang kadali, di ba? 40,000 minus 5,000 multiplied by 4,000 all over 15,000 units. So solving further, the depreciated amount is 35,000 multiplied by 4,000 divided by 15,000. The depreciated amount of the machine will be 9,330 pesos. Ganun lang kadali. So that is capital service output method class. If you will have any question, feel free to message me or comment down in this video. Until the next module. Thank you and God bless you.